Pugs are no doubt one of the most popular dog breeds in the United States. And I get it, they're very sweet and good family dogs too. They also look pretty darn cute on the surface. But these dogs have some severe health problems that can't be ignored. If you've ever owned a pug, or watched videos of them before, then you probably know about those seemingly cute noises they make when they breathe. You know what I'm talking about. Well, if you knew what those sounds meant, then you shouldn't think it's cute at all, because those little breathing sounds means they are constantly suffocating all the time. The reason they have this problem is because they've been inbred over time to make their snout so short that they literally have no snout at all. And I'm not even joking, take a look at this example of their skull. Yeah, that's real. These breathing problems make them unable to exercise enough or socialize with other dogs. Simply going for a walk for very long at all will cause them to overheat. And by the way, if you own a pug, make sure to keep the air conditioner on, because if it isn't, your poor little dog will suffocate to death. I've heard a horror story about an owner's electricity going out, which caused their pug to die because it couldn't breathe without the air conditioner on. Not only do they have breathing problems, they also have a large variety of others, including pug dog encephalitis, canine hip dysplasia, paralysis caused by their unnaturally curled tails, and a condition that causes their eyes to fall out called eyeproptosis. I can't imagine how these poor dogs feel all the time, when their life is literally the equivalent of hell. Pugs once were well accepted by people, just the way they were before the 20th century, and they were cute. But then aristocrats came along and started the Kennel Club, where they compared dog breeds and decided pugs weren't cute enough. They thought they'd be cuter if their snouts were smashed in with a frying pan, their hind legs sawed in half so they wouldn't be proportionate to their body, and their tails curled so much they are structurally broken. That's basically what they ended up doing, even if it wasn't what they specifically wanted. They suffer for what the modern world regards as cute, and aren't accepted for what they originally were anymore, which is sad and downright cruel. Of course, pugs aren't the only dogs that have been inbred for humanity's preference and aesthetics. To name just a few of the worst, there's the Bull Terrier, the Cavalier King Charles Spaniel, the Dachshund, and the English Bulldog. But the reason this video is about pugs is because they are the most popular breed with the most serious health issues. Pure breeding really needs to stop, because continuing to do so counts as animal cruelty at this point. Crossbreeding them would easily save this breed, and luckily it's actually happening. There's a new breed called the Retro Pug, which is a cross with a pug and a Jack Russell Terrier. They're basically what pugs used to look like before the Kennel Nation attacked. It makes me happy to know that people care for pugs enough to fix their health conditions the best they can. Anyway, yeah, purebreeding dogs needs to be banned for animal cruelty, because that's what it is. What do you think?